Welcome back. We'll finish up those Indian blanket flowers now. I come back in with, this is cadmium red light, and I'm going to start putting my petals in. And I have to carefully lay that paint on top of the green, because if I dig it in, see how my brush picks up that green, and I don't get nice crisp color. So I just have to be very, very gentle in laying that paint on. I'm going to bring that center down on that a little bit. I use a lot of tissue. This, we just buy the cheapest tissue you can get. Jack would always say it's John Wayne tissue. It won't take the off of anybody. But as he always said, it's really not fit for human use, but it's great for keeping our brushes clean. And there'd be a few little kind of buds of flowers coming out. And I just about wipe my brush every time I put a couple strokes down. Now I'm going to make this a little bit darker here toward the middle. And now this is, I'm using some cadmium red deep right here just because that flower's down kind of in shadow a little bit. This one, some of the petals are in shadow. Now I'm going to come back in with, this is a mixture of mud plus liquid, and my mud is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson, and I mix that with liquid, and that just gives it just a little bit, just makes it flow a little bit better. And I start adding the centers of these. Petals on this one. Go ahead and use my cadmium red light here. I'm going to add a few little stems. I have my reference material. I have a tabouret next to my easel, and I put my laptop up there. And then that way I can look, I have my reference material right there. It's so wonderful with digital files. I can enlarge anything as large as I want it. If I want to see details or whatever, I can do that. Okay, now to add the yellow on the tips of these petals, I just come back and start adding the yellows. Little larger brush, and this is cadmium yellow medium. Come back in and add a little more of my, this is kind of a back and forth process, this step. Just those other ones I got too much yellow on. That's my fault. Let's just go back. Put our cadmium red deep in here. There we go. Yeah, that's more like it. Just the tips of the petals are the yellow. If we get into the shadow, I'm going to add a little bit of mud into my cadmium yellow medium. This, a little bit of mud and just a tiny bit of orange. And this just darkens it, makes it shadowy. Now he's up here catching the light. The light's coming into the painting from the right side. So these are my now down here, these are getting to be in shadow. See how that's a darker? That yellow's darker. Now this one's catching a little bit of light. And this one down here will be dark. Even this little bud has just a few little tips of yellow. Now the centers of these flowers are also lighter yellow. And I'm going to make that with my darker shadow color yellow. Because it's not as bright as the one time we were down at the beach in Corpus Christi, actually on North Padre Island. We lived there for a couple of years. And in the springtime, these plants were all along the beach. So Jack started calling them beach plants. So that name has always kind of stuck in my mind. As I call the Indian blankets beach plants too. So now I need to make this just a little bit darker. Just a little shade darker because these are in shadow. So I add a little bit more of the mud, which is ultramarine blue plus alizarin crimson. Just make that a little bit darker, not a bunch. Now I'm going to, on these that are really in the light sun, really catching the sun, I am going to add just a touch of the cadmium yellow medium. And our little bud up there is actually, we're seeing him kind of from the side, so we're not going to see a center in him. Have a little petal there. And I got some red into my background there, which I want to be back into my roses. So I just take a little bit of my leaf color from my roses and come back in and fix that. Just bring a little bit of a this flower's coming in behind Hobo's hip. And I can even brace on the unpainted part of the canvas to steady my hand as I do these flowers back here. And that'll have a center in it. Do a little more red. This is where the finishing out is where the time. They block in pretty quickly, but then it slows down as you start adding the little details. And you work each individual flower. This comes in behind his hip. Green's picking up and I'm not getting my red petal here. There we go. Go ahead and put that center back in. And then do the yellow on the center. Make that a little brighter. I'm going to bring a little more red right here. Well, again, you have to be real careful. You just have to lay the paint on there, or else you pick up that green underneath. Now I'm going to bring that flower's kind of sideways, so we're not seeing the whole round front view of it like we are these. You have to work these. I mean, they just don't always come together exactly like you want them to the first time. Okay, now I've got that red in. A little bit of a halo around that yellow on the center. I'll just take a smaller brush and do that. And now I want to do my yellow here. It comes back behind him. There we go. And that's how I finish out the Indian blanket flowers. I will do all of them. This just shows you. And then at the end of this video, I'll have a frame that shows the Indian blanket flowers all finished. I really thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I also have a blog. The link is in the description below. And the address is also on the final frame of the video. And there I show the complete step-by-step process of this painting as well as others that I do. So you have a great day, and I thank you again so much for visiting our studio.